AI is a very interesting term that I think, you know, artificial intelligence, anything that you deal with nowadays, it's in the papers, it's in the news. You know, how are we using it? Well, I'll say one, we're already using it.
We're trying to predict either the intercepts.
So I say that we are very involved in it and we are very aware that it's ever changing. It's really kind of spiked over the past couple of years and the interest of it.
Hi everyone, my name is Baxter and I am a robot.
I was reading not too long ago that they think that artificial intelligence, career field-wise, is going to be the most sought-after career field on the outside for years to come. They don't have enough students in the AI pipeline to fill the requirements on the outside, and I would say that in the Air Force, we were already aware of that, and we're trying to push more students through the AI track here at Afit for that same reason, because we know we need those experts out there to explain these concepts at the big tables to the senior leadership who may read that word, like, what is neural net, what is deep learning? Look at that guy, hey, I know you went to Afit, what do you know about it? And they can talk about it.
The robot's doing pretty well if you think about all those things. So when it goes over obstacles.
We make our investments sometimes in basic technologies like the robotics capabilities you're seeing here, sometimes in very specific military systems like when we demonstrated the first stealth aircraft a number of decades ago. And in either case, what we want to do is get the technology progress happening so that ultimately we can make a huge change in national security.
We're starting to advance further into what I would say is the next kind of big thing is autonomy, where we want machines to work on their own because that can save you resources and manpower. Right now, we kind of have one pilot for one bird. We would like in the Air Force to have maybe one pilot with multiple birds, but the only way to do that is if those UAVs or PAs can do some decision making on their own. Maybe path planning, how do I get from point A to point B so a pilot doesn't have to figure all that out for them. You know, ISR of a certain region to flag on something of interest so an operator doesn't have to sit there and watch that feed continuously. They get notified and then they could maybe move over to that box and say, oh, okay, let me look at this a little bit more to make that. And so I think that's really where you're going to see AI starting to incorporate from the Air Force perspective is helping the operator deal with almost information overload now, since everything is so connected and we have so much information coming in, we can use AI techniques to start parsing that down.